From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
This more often. My name is Betsy Peterson, and I want to say welcome to all of you. I am the director of the American Folklife Center here at the Library of Congress, and on behalf of the staff and indeed everyone here at the library, I want to welcome you all this evening for a very special concert. The homegrown concert series, of which this is the culminating concert, and I think it's very fitting that that is the case. The Homegrown Concert Series allows the American Folklife Center to present the very best traditional artists from around the country. We work with folklorists and cultural specialists around the country to identify individuals and bring them here to share their art with all of you and with all of us. And so this is going to be a wonderful evening. With these concerts, we also record them, and we will be recording them tonight, and it will eventually be webcast, put up on our website, so that individuals from throughout the world will be able to hear this concert, and future generations will be able to listen in as well. So, as a result, I just want to ask you, no pictures this evening, and to please turn off your cell phones. Out of respect to all the beautiful music we are about to hear. Also, I want to say that in beginning the concert, I am only the MC and the individual who is going to bring on the person who is going to introduce Flory this evening. His name is John Lohman, and he is the coordinator of the Virginia Folklife Program based in Charlottesville and based at the Virginia Foundation for the Humanities. And he was going to give us a little bit of background about Flory Jagoda and the music we are about to hear tonight. So please give him a warm welcome.
Thank you. Isn't this a beautiful evening? What an amazing event. It's just such an honor to get to introduce someone tonight who's really, I'd say a national treasure, but really just a treasure to the world, a gift to the world. She's all of our Nona, I think. I got to meet Flory the first time. It was about 11 or 12 years ago when I started in my position as state folklorist in Virginia. And the National Endowment for the Arts announced who would be receiving the National Heritage Fellowships, which, for those of you who don't know, that's the highest honor that the United States bestows on a traditional artist. So part of my thing is to look at it and to see, is there anybody there from Virginia? And there it was, this beautiful woman from Falls Church that year received the National Heritage Fellowship, which is the highest honor that the U.S. gives to a traditional artist. So that's really something. So I called Flory, and just a beautiful woman. We just had a wonderful conversation, and she told me about her grandmother, and she told me about this Ladino language, which I didn't know as much about as I should and have since, and the Altaras family, and about her life, and I was just so taken by her. And one of the things she told me when we were talking, too, is that she had a real concern about this language, which, of course, dates back to the late 15th century, and further, that it is preserved and that this music that she learned from her grandmother and that her family sang also carry on. And so she has taught many people, as you'll see tonight, that you're going to just be a wonderful representation of all the people who've been touched by Flory and her music. It also encouraged us at the foundation to begin an apprenticeship program, which we started that year, Folklife Apprenticeship Program, where we pair masters and apprentices of all different types of traditional art forms. And Flory was in it the very first year. She apprenticed a young woman named Susan Gaeta, who many of you may know. Yes, Susan. And Susan is Susan is going to be here tonight, and it was just an amazing experience that they had together. And Susan was so touched by the experience that she created, in Flory's name, the Flory Jagoda Sephardic Music Fund at our foundation. Her and her father started that, and I just want to give them appreciation. That's such an incredible thing. And it has allowed, it's helped to make this concert possible tonight, the filming that's going to take place, as well as future apprenticeships. So this year, Flory's the first person to do it again. 10 years later, she's apprenticing a young woman named Aviva Chernik, who you'll see tonight, who's also a fantastic singer. So in your programs, there is a little bit about that fund. Many of you have donated, and if you care to, it will help to carry this on. And it'd be wonderful testament to Flory's work. And I just wanted to say, since that phone call, I've gotten to know Flory real well. I've been fortunate enough to get to go to her Seder a couple times. The food, by the way. Flory is, we know Flory is a singer. I have to tell you, I think a lot of you are her friends, so you've probably been to her home, either in Falls Church or now Alexandria. And when you walk in, one thing you see are beautiful paintings all over the wall. Flory's an amazing painter. Well, I never knew that until I walked into her home. Beautiful paintings, instruments all over the walls. As I said, incredible food in the kitchen, and also there's a room overlooking the river that just has posters of concerts she's done and festivals she's been at, and letters that people have written her thanking her. And you see that her impact is all over the world. Absolutely global. In fact, we had a really fun time. One time I showed her YouTube, and we sat in front of YouTube, and we typed in Ocho Candelicas on YouTube. I recommend you try that. It's amazing. You'll see a children's choir in Italy and then all over the world. There's even like a punk rock band from Iceland does a cover of the song. And we had so much fun. And every time when I think of Flory, I think of laughter and joy, and I think you all do too. And we all know that, she came from a very, very difficult, horrible situation that none of us could imagine, what happened to the Sephardic community in Sarajevo and throughout Europe, and that she was able to escape from. And what always strikes me about her is that her music and her life and the way she is, she's so joyous and so positive. And to me, that's just such a testament, I think, kind of to the human spirit, and also to what music can do for that. And so I just feel so blessed to be able to say this, which is that I really want you all to welcome, it's such an honor to do this, Ms. Flory Jagoda.
Good evening. It is so good to be here and see this beautiful sight in front of me. I am so pleased that we have this evening where I have an opportunity for you to share my songs, my life stories. So we will start in fact, I want you to know, they put me in this chair and they said, this is where you sit and don't get up. That's a chair for the whole evening. So I'm going to be here and you'll see me a whole evening. This is Shabbat. The customary thing for any evening that is personally meaningful to you is to do a biraha. Biraha is a prayer. The one that tonight I would like to start with is Bendición de Madre, the biraha, the prayer, the mother blesses her children. You have, I'm very proud of the programs you have, and I think my daughter Betty went through all this problem and troubles to do the translation, so you can follow me. Padre Santo, en esa clara celemora, que estoy dispuesta para bendecir a mis hijos, siguiendo el deseo de madre que consiento, sea Dios siempre pronto. A escuchar de los altos cielos mi oración y bendición, que yo bendigo a mis hijos. Mi Dios, tú que me hiciste alargar la vida, en dándome hijos a mi lado, hazme esta bondad, en presentamelos para buena vida y ventura, y merecime con mis ojos sus mazal, y sus prospero y florecido. Padre piadoso.
Thank you.
The Padre Piadoso really heard me, and I have my whole family here. I'll start with my granddaughter. This is Ariel Law. We are going to start this beautiful program that I'm very, very, I can consider myself lucky to have so many musical friends. And students, that will all we have a chance to share the songs that we sing, play, study, teach, learn. We are starting with l'amour, a word that has been used for centuries in every country. Love.
Amores como las flores, la más dulzura de mucha color, como la rosa dulce y rosada. El guesmo de fresco y jazmín. Amor es como las flores, la morosura de mucha color.
Vez con amor viene buena vista como la rosa dulce y rosada y las flores de las flores
y las flores
de
Betty, Uncle Elliot, and Mother Lori.
Oh, I thought I have to leave, but I don't. Good mishpacha. You know what's a mishpacha? Family. Definitely you still sing together as we do in love. And also tell many stories. In my family, I always tell them what it used to be long time ago. One of the stories that is really wedding, the main thing is that the family teaches the future bride what to do and what not to do. So this family has a daughter who is going to get married, and before the wedding, the whole family sits down with the bride and they tell her, this is what you do, this is what you don't do, and this is what you do. The main thing is that they tell her, when you meet il suegro, who knows what suegro? Father-in-law. Call him my dear father. You meet la suegra, call her my dear new mother. So it goes through the whole family. So this is a song we're going to sing for you, and let's get going. This is how I handle them. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And now I think they're all, you're all going to start, aren't you?
Yes, we are going to start.
See?
Quiere ser bien servido.
all still with the wedding. The weddings go on and on and on, you know, don't stop. So this wedding, really, we go to a young bride who had some tough times because the custom, the old Bosnian weddings, Bosnian Sephardic weddings, was that the bride had to embroider a beautiful vest, like what Elliot's wearing. Yes, you know, pretty well. Okay. And the problem was for the brides is they had to embroider this beautiful vest, which would hang in the synagogue, alkal, so people can see how clever and artistic the bride is.
Flory, you did that, didn't you?
Yes.
So, I don't want to go into family, now that we have a lot of problems here, okay? This bride had a problem. She never made it to finish the vest before the wedding. Now that was a big problem for the family, because everybody would, after the wedding, they would see the vest, they would say, my God, she's so talented. How do you do it? So this song is about this bride and the vest. As every, who did that?
I did. Sorry, I was early. I thought you were ready. It's going to be a long night.
I think this only happens in America. It really does. Because in Bosnia, where I was born, mother said, who did that? She said, I did, Mom. Not in America. All right, so we are going to start with a beautiful song. I think it's a beautiful song. Why? Because I wrote it. But they are not singing it the way I taught them. So it's America again, see? But let's try anyway. So, il bastidor is the vest, and this is what we call it in Bosnian Sephardic language, il bastidor. So, what am I doing?
No,
I'm doing
this.
I just sing, I'm told. I don't play. Let's go. Viene ce che so e scomparto, viene marito a si piva scevo. Quando che vos labro este lindo passido, che vos labro este lento passito. La 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 la. Marito a si piva chevo. Quando che vos labro este lindo bastido. Cuando que vos labró este lindo bastido. La 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 la. Cuando que vos celebro este lindo bastido. Cuando que vos celebro este lindo bastido. La 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 la. Just going to sit here because I was told sit.
Hi. Good to see everybody. Welcome. So my two little friends here, Susan and Betsy, will be singing with me. Our group is called Colors of the Flame. And we derived from playing an honorary concert for my mother way back in 1995. David Schneer, one of the gentlemen who's on stage with us from the Jewish Folk Art Society, invited us to do a concert in honor of my mother, so I had to put a group together really quick. And did so, called my friends, said, come over, let's see if we can put a couple of songs together. We started singing, and it sounded pretty sweet. This is good. So then I called my brother and my sister, and I said, you got to hear this, come on, we're going to play this honorary concert. We put a medley together, and it was really special and really fun, kind of stuck. So here we are, singing about love once again. So remember the first time you fell in love?
maybe when you were 18 years old and you got that little flutter in your stomach and you were really excited. Well, this song represents that, being in the spring of your youth and falling in love and not really knowing what to do. And nowadays we just pray that they'll call.
Caminando por la plaza, encontré una mujer. Sus cabellos rubios, su gracia era de ver. Sus cabellos rubios, su gracia era de ver. Por ti, mi linda dama, daré mi vida entera. Por ti, mi corazón me se desespera. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que haré. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que años tengo en la flor de mi mancebés. Me quemantes en un fuego por la primera vez. Me quemantes en un fuego por la primera vez. Por ti, mi linda dama, daré mi vida entera. Por ti, mi corazón me se desespera. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que haré. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que diré. Encontré una mujer, sus cabellos rubios, su gracia era de ver. Sus cabellos rubios, su gracia era de ver. Por ti, linda dama, daré mi vida entera. Por ti, mi corazón me se desespera. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que haré. No sé lo que haré, no sé lo que
the stories that I always tell my children, most of it is always about my family in Vlasenica, which is a village outside of Sarajevo, where I was born. And I always tell them about my tias. Tia is an aunt. I had a lot of tias. I had tia Mazalta, tia Gracia, tia Luna, tia Safira, tia Estrella. The family was large. The beauty of it was, you don't feel good, your mother is not well, there is always a tia who would come and help and cook and take care of us. So I have written a story about las tias. And let's play it. Let's play about tia Mazalta. They each had a holiday that we would all come to celebrate together. So tia Mazalta usually would have us for Hanukkah. Tia Luna would have us for Noci di Haggadah, Pesach. Tia Mazalta, we already had dinner, so it goes to Tia Paloma. Tia Paloma had vamos a comer en la suka. That means we ate in a suka. So let's musically take them to Vlasenica and sing about our last tears now, okay? Here we go.
Thank you. frío de invierno, entre mis brazos me se murió. Y desde entonces voy por el mundo con el recuerdo de aquel amor.
¿Dónde estás, corazón? No te siento palpitar. Que es tan grande dolor que no puedo llorar. Que no quería llorar, mas no tengo más a tú. Yo quería tanto y se fue para nunca más turnar.
Una mañana del frío de invierno, entre mis brazos me se murió. Y desde entonces voy por el mundo con el recuerdo de aquel amor.
¿Dónde estás, corazón? No te siento palpitar. Que es tan grande el dolor que no puedo llorar. Yo quería llorar, mas no tengo más a la quería tanto y se fue para nunca más tú.
I'm Susan Gaeta, and I'm so happy to see everyone here tonight. And I've studied with Flory for a long time, I think, along with Howard and Tina, and we like to play one of her pieces called Johannino. It means, I am handsome, Johannina, you are beautiful, let's get married, right? It should be that simple, and we'll have children like the luna and the sol, like the sun and the moon. Johannino, Johannina, mos tomare, mos los dos, los hijicos que hemos nacen como la luna y el sol. Los hijicos que hemos nacen como la luna y el sol. Gracias, mancebo, que mandates corredor. Muchas liras me demanda, no me acepta mi señor. Muchas liras me demanda, no me acepta mi señor. Amaravanavanavanavanavan, no me acepta mi señor. Thank you.
tomaremos los dos los hijos que hemos nacen como la luna y el sol los hijos que hemos nacen como la luna y el sol
song that they just sang is, I'm handsome, you beautiful, let's get married. That is the beauty of the song that is very cheerful and very pretty. Now from cheerful to not so cheerful, we go back to a little bit what I went through before coming to America. When I came to America, I actually brought a suitcase full of memories. Good memories, bad memories. The bad memories always is going back to Europe, where I come from, where we had some tough times. In April 21, the German soldiers marched through Zagreb, where I lived. My father came home shaking. We have to get out. We have to get out. Get out. Where are we going to go? I was just a nice, happy teenager studying harmonica, having good time with my friends, going to the river swimming. Don't ask, my father said, pack up, we are going. I have to leave Zagreb. Tomorrow we're taking a train. Daddy, where are we going? What shall I take with me? I thought we're going on a trip. You take nothing. You just take your harmonica. Because I was an accordionist, as Deb would say here. And every town, every house had a party. There was always, don't forget your harmonica. I always was playing music and writing little songs way, way back. My father said, get on a plane. I mean, train, not plane, train, choo-choo. Choo-choo train, I would tell my children here. Just don't talk. Nemoj govoriti. I wrote this little song after my little 2 days of tremendous pressure. But I did go to that train the next day, taken by a friend that lived next door. And with my non-Jewish names on a ticket, I got in a train. And my father said, just play your harmonica. Don't say a word. Well, I sat in a compartment, you know, in a train that they have 6 people to a compartment or 8. Wartime, a lot of women with babushkas and chickens and soldiers. Very, very full place around me. And I just sat, play my accordion, my harmonica. In Europe, you get to a compartment like this. If somebody starts singing in this parts of the world, in Bosnia, they love to sing. they all started singing with me. It became a party. The conductor never even asked me for my ticket. So he sat down, Owens started singing and playing with us. I went as far as City of Split, called, and in Italian they would call it Spalato. I did arrive in Spalato, and some friends were waiting for me. I saved my life. We were taken after that to island of Korčula, and we were interned there for 2.5 years. And I wrote this little song. I'd like to share it with you. So, my friends, my dear friends, will accompany me. It's not so happy, but it is successful. It is something I treasure and something I celebrate, that my harmonica saved my life. I sang it in Bosnia. Tata Mika. Did reach Spalato, and we have a beautiful song about Spalato, the beautiful city on the Croatian coast.
Thank you.
quiero contigo, mi amore. Una vez más a nuestro María. Quiero contigo, mi amore. Una vez más a nuestro María.
Was the best gift to me in my life. My nona, well, she was very religious. I mean, she spoke to us only in Ladino, Judeo-Spanish. And she was a midwife too. She was a believer in a song. If you were a seed, she would say, canta, sing. You will feel better. The song is a healer. I have written this little song about her, and this is the only way you can keep with a person. A song can keep you entire together. She was a midwife. 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning, you would hear the door. The little one is arriving. We didn't know if it's a boy and a girl. You know, a long time ago. But everybody was expecting Il Chico. It had to be a boy. Because the father would say, Ken va maldar la Torah? Who is going to read the Torah? We have to have a boy. This was the thinking years ago. So, I have a wonderful accompanist. That's Howard. So, he always makes songs pretty. Cada noche de Shabbat mi ricordo de mi nonna con la luz de las candelas baldando sus virajas. Cada noche de Shabbat mi ricordo di mi nonna con la luz de las candelas maldando sus virajas. Longas noches del invierno asentada en el minder, mus cantaba las canticas y las lindas consejicas de amor. Mus cantaba las canticas y las lindas consejicas de amor. Na, ni, na, na, ni, na. Me dormía con su chamada, mos cantaba las canticas y las lindas consejicas y las lindas consejicas de amor. Nanina. Mus cantaba la Shema, mus cantaba las canticas y las lindas consejicas y las lindas consejicas de amor. Cada noche de Shabbat.
Her songs. Tomorrow marks 5 years since we took our first lesson with Flory, and we have sung every week since then.
A wonderful student. Six of them came to me one day. Teachers.
We have been many tias. Tonight we have Luna, Elena, Paloma, and myself.
They call themselves las tias, the aunts.
Our second song tonight is going to be about keeping the Sabbath. But before we can get to the Sabbath, we have to create the world. And our first song is the creation of the world in Latin.
Shabbat. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Aviva is my next apprentice. The first apprentice for Susan, worked with me for many, many years. Today, Susan gives concerts. She teaches. Well, definitely performs with me. And I'm very, very proud of her. This is my next one, Aviva. Aviva comes from Taranto, isn't it? She flies down to a lesson, which is she really wants to learn.
When I'm really lucky, my boyfriend drives the 10 hours with me, so thank you, Carlos. I just want to say that, sorry. Stand. But just want to say it's worth 10 hours and more to drive, to study, and spend time with Flory. And I want to tell you that you've made my life much richer.
You made my life wonderful too. I love it.
So now some Torah.
She's a cantor. So expects now something.
Okay, some teaching. Get ready. So, this song is from Akedat Yitzchak, from the binding of Isaac. In the beginning, we have Abraham preparing to sacrifice at God's bidding his only child, if you can imagine.
I can imagine.
A son, Yitzchak. We don't hear anything from Yitzchak. He's totally silent the entire time. We don't know him until this moment when he finally speaks. And he states, seems like a question, but he states the obvious. We have fire. We have wood. But where is the animal for sacrifice? Abraham quiso a santificar a su hijo y su alma atada con su alma lo encoronó con leños y su fuego.
Leggero come il corno rispondio e dice mi signor padre il fuoco il legno ti ne
su cabeza
do add songs in Bosnian language, Serbian, the former Yugoslavian, because at home we spoke only Judeo-Spanish. But the moment you come to the steps of your house, the nona would say, "Habla en Gio." She would not let you speak anything but Judeo-Spanish. This is how we learn. But I also went to school, local school, learned all the Bosnian folk songs, and still sing them and add them to my programs. So this one here is Ptičice, little birds. And it says the little birds went south. Only one remained, and that is the one me to sing to you. So let's all sing our Ptičice. Let's go. I don't hear. Sve ptičice iz gore, sve ptičice iz gore. Sve ptičice iz gore, pustile se na more. Sve ptičice iz gore, pustile se na more. A song about I'm going to war. I'm throwing two kisses. One kiss is for my madre, para mi madre, y otro es para ti, niña de mi corazón. The one is to my mother, and the other one is for you, niña, little girl of my heart. You're singing with me? Who's singing with me? Tiffany. Tiffany. Oh. Italy, Italia. But we sing beautiful together. She gives me a great harmony. Okay, let's go. Who's singing? Who's playing? Ah. This is...
Where are you from?
Spain. See, we're a mixture of many things, but that's why sometimes you mix and you make good music together.
Let's go.
Sure. Dos beijos al aire yo eché, uno es para mi madre y otro es para ti, niña de mi corazón, y otro es para ti. Quien piensa de se enamorar, que fue cada luna, que lunar es mentiroso, sabe. Hecho a mí, lo dejo para ti. Ella llena de dolor, lo dejo para ti. ¿Quién piensa de se enamorar? Que fue cada luna, que lunar es mentiroso. Sitting comfortable. This is a funny one. A young woman says to her mom, "Mother, la madre, if I die, I don't want cantors to carry my coffin." Isn't that say coffin? "I want 12 young men to carry it and to see what they missed." So that is funny, isn't it? Madre mía, si me muero. Mother mine, if I die. Madre mía, si me muero, hazanim no quiero yo, sino todos los más ricos, adelante mi arroz, alba chequerula, alba chequerula. It is a custom that at the end of life, let's say, the family has eats sweets. Halva, you know that halva is sweet. Sheker, ola. Sheker is sugar. Ola is nothing. Ola just rhymes. So, right? We need something to finish the third line. Halva, Shrekker, Ola. All right, one more song. Is there one more song? One more song. And that is the most popular song in Bosnia. It was years ago, and it still is today. Adio, querida. A lot of you probably know it. Sing it with us. Lala with us. Whatever. Join. The melody is very beautiful. So let's go. And you're ready.
Tu madre cuando te parió y te quitó al mundo. Corazón ella no te dio para amar, ser.
puška te otra amor. Ajalva otras puertas, espera otra ardor, que para mí sos mortal. Espera otra ardor, que para mí sos muerta.
Hear a song, even if you don't know the lyrics, learn it, but just say la, 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 do the la, la, let's go.
Adio.
Sit back.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.